Nurse managers really get the raw end of the deal. They are vital in the hospital role and yet get very little formal training in their position. One of my students was working as a nurse manager, working 80 hours a week, plus the 24/7 call that you have to take in a busy OR. And here is her story. Hi, I'm Catie Harris, owner and CEO of NursePreneurs, a company that empowers nurses to start businesses. Now, I want to tell you about my student, Kimball. So Kimball worked for the OR for 20 years at her hospital. She was a great nurse and was eventually just tapped on the shoulder to become the nurse manager of that OR. Now, Kimball is a diligent and hardworking individual, and it took her maybe a year or so to figure out what her role was and what she was supposed to be doing. So, but despite all the ups and downs and all the challenges, Kimball ended up being a really good nurse manager. The problem was that the role was never ending, right? What originally started out as a challenge and it was exciting, and it eventually became just life draining. It felt like every time she walked into the OR, it was the first time. And no matter how many frameworks or protocols and initiatives that she put into place to make that system flow even better, it always seemed to keep breaking down. Now, the nurse manager role is stressful and constant. One day she would have an angry surgeon screaming at her because that OR room was canceled for who knows what reason, right? Or a nurse was crying because maybe another surgeon was, she was the target of another surgeon who was yelling and screaming and throwing things around for whatever reason. But having staff members who call out. So instead of working on the budget, Kimball actually had to fill in as a circulating nurse. Here she is, the nurse manager has to fill in. And in fact, when Kimball first called me about starting a business, I thought she was a little crazy. I said, where in the world are you going to have time to do this? On top of it all, her husband had just been laid off as well. So she was the sole breadwinner with four kids. But Kimball was persistent. After 30 years in the hospital system, she realized that she was not getting anywhere and that nothing was ever going to be organized, no matter how organized she was. There were just too many factors that kept sabotaging her attempts to create a system. There were too many egos to contend with. And, you know, quite frankly, she was just tired of bringing work home to do on weekends and holidays and being on constant call. The life of a nurse manager is exhausting. And it took Kimball and I a while to figure out what it was that she was going to do. But she did decide to set up a concierge nurse business to start. She thought, okay, I know a lot of surgeons and, you know, I should be able to connect with them and get them to send patients to me. And that is where she did start. But as soon as she started the business, opportunities started to come to her, and Kimball was approached by someone who had heard that she had a business but didn't really know what it was. But anyway, she asked if Kimball could do IV infusions for a local gym, and Kimball was not one to shy away from a challenge, despite all of the things that she had going on. So she said, sure, yeah, why not? And she came home and she called me. She's like, oh my God, what have I done? So, you know, at that time, she didn't know anything about IV hydration and didn't know how to set that business up. So we got busy working together to figure out all of the pieces. And within weeks, that IV hydration business was ready and she started generating income. Kimball started doing infusions on a weekly basis at the gym. And now she had the side hustle, but she's still the nurse manager. She's still working 80 hours and 24/7 call. So after a while, she really felt like she was burning the candle at both ends. However, a consistent paycheck is like a bad habit. It is so hard to give up, and especially when you're making six figures a year with benefits. We grow really dependent on that income, and Kimball was convinced that she needed this pay and continued in both roles for some time. But I mean, eventually one day Kimball just found out that every time she went into the hospital system, she was really just angry. And I can totally get that feeling. It's why I started my business myself, because I found myself angry and irritated with everyone, and it's not who I was or what I wanted to be. I told her she would have to make a decision eventually, and probably sooner rather than later, or one would ultimately be made for her. So Kimball decided to step down from her role as the nurse manager and work part-time with benefits, which she was fortunate to be able to do. And this allowed her to expand her current business, which in the role that she had, it wasn't enough to support her full time, but you know, without more time, she couldn't make it expand. But now she had time to make new partnerships that had the potential to grow. Within a year and a half of starting that business, Kimball found the courage to leave the hospital system. She discovered affordable benefits, began a partnership with a local wellness collective, and that collective actually provided her with more benefits, such as free access to their Pilates gym, or their cryotherapy, which I've done and it's really cool, or their red light therapy and more. And in fact, Kimball started to lose weight herself and generate more income. She generated more income in 1 month than she did in the year prior as the nurse manager. Plus she was happier. And all of this was possible only because Kimball wanted something more for herself, even though she didn't really know what it was to begin with. Once she began to focus on what it was that she wanted and started searching for a way to get it, her life started to change. And this is just one of the amazing stories of success that our nursepreneurs have had in starting a business. The fact is, you are on a path to somewhere. And if you want to know where that path leads, look at people who are 5 to 10 years ahead of you, who have been in that position for 5 to 10 years longer than you have. And if that's not the path that you want, if that's not where you want to go, you need to get off of that path. Starting an IV hydration business is only one of the many businesses that we help nurses to get started in. So if you want to learn more about IV hydration, you want to watch this next video on how to get started. If you want to find out what other businesses we have, then you can check us out at nursepreneurs.com, and we look forward to working with you.